So let's start from the same thing again and again. We are going to enter in a new month, okay? That is the month of April, and the one quarter is already over, okay? So there can be a quarterly shift, but let's focus on let's start with the DXY and with a monthly chart, okay? Okay, so the close is important. So when you see what happened last month, that we opened here and price came back, okay, and it closed above. So definitely it's not a bearishness signs for DXY, but as of now what I can see is that the drawn liquidity for next month could be the February month high. This can be a drawn liquidity as price fails to close below this low. Okay, so the automatically my drawn liquidity will be, okay, let me use the icon which I used to, where is it, where is the I? Okay, so let's use this one. Okay, so the drawn liquidity will be this February month high, okay? And why this will be a drawn liquidity? Because price fails to close below this February low, so this will be my drawn liquidity, okay? And what I can see here is that there is also an order block here. So that order block also makes sense, because the order block is just above the February high. So what I can expect in the month of April, that this price to tap this order block as well as take out this February month high, and we can see some retracement or reversal from here. Okay, so this is all about the monthly chart, what I can infer from the chart. Let's go to the weekly, and in weekly there's a interesting thing here. Price closed above this candle, that makes this an order block, okay? And we also have a fair value gap here, okay? But there is one more interesting thing here. This is a weekly order block, as well as this candle is also an order block. This is a monthly order block, and this candle is also an order block in weekly chart. That makes this area a high probability area, okay, to take short, or the high priority area for our drawn liquid. Okay, so this is my February month high, and this is the February gap. So most probably people will expect that price can come and tap this February gap, okay, and we will take out this February high. That would be the ideal scenario, but doesn't need to come immediately, okay? The best thing is to wait for price to come here, not to short from here till this February gap, because there can also be possibility that price will take out February high without tapping this February gap, and we'll keep on trying shorting the market, and you will ultimately get wrecked because you are trying to go against the trend. So the best thing is to do either to wait for price to come to this weekly fair value gap, and then only you place a trade, let's go to the daily time frame. What do we have in daily time frame? Or you wait for an PD array to form here to target this weekly fair value gap. How can you do? Price has closed above this candle, so when you see the next candle, the month of April, take out this high, or without taking out this high, price closed below this low, okay, so below this candle, also filling this volume imbalance, okay, this volume imbalance, if it fills this gap and price closed below this, now this candle will become my order block, okay. Now that will then at that time it will be ideal to take a shot from this area to target this fair value gap. okay, if it is not happening, if it is not happening, then what you can do, you wait for price to come back here, okay, then you short, then you long from here, else you wait for price to form to create a PD array which is bearish PD array from here in daily time frame, then you can target this weekly favorable gap. Okay, yes, daily looks good, weekly looks much more clear than the daily. So the ideal scenario will be price taking out, coming to this favorable gap and targeting this favorable high as well as the week, the monthly order block. But the case where this idea got invalidates when you see this order block. Okay, this order block got invalidated. Okay, then only this whole scenario get invalidates. But until then, the idea is bullish in DXY, and the draw on liquidity will be this February high and also this monthly order block. Okay, and just in case this thing happen, suppose price neither created a order block here nor it came to this favorable gap, weekly favorable gap, so how can you target this February high? So to target this February high, I would like to see a creation of a bullish PD array. Okay, either here, if it creates a bullish PD array here, how it can do, if price closed above this candle high, okay, suppose the next candle open and it came down, take out this candle liquidity, and it has closed above this high. Okay, so it has closed above this high, and then in that case this candle becomes my order block, bullish order block, and I can target from this candle to this February high. Okay, so this is also a possibility, which there are three possibility. Price can directly take out this February high, or price will come to this weekly February gap, then take out the February high. Okay, and there are three ways to participate. One way is to wait for price to come to this weekly February gap and targeting this February high. Else, one more way is to shorting from here to this February gap, but this is a risky one. So what will you do? You will wait for a order block to form here, or a PD array, February gap, or a breakout to form here, and target this weekly February gap. Else, if price created a bullish PD array here, you can directly target this February high. Price may not come to this weekly February gap. So that is all possibility, but overall the bias will be bullish. Okay, hope you got the idea, everyone. Okay, so now let's go to the one more chart. Let's go to the Euro USD. Okay, the Euro USD, I saw something interesting today. So let's start from the monthly. What do we have in monthly? When you see in monthly, okay, so the monthly, it looks nothing, like it's very difficult to say it's going to happen. So let's go to weekly then. Okay, so the weekly the bias, it looks bearish. What PD array we have a tiny favorable gap here. So there is a possibility that when DXY taps the weekly bullish favorable gap in that time, this DX euro can tap this weekly bearish favorable gap. But there is thing in 3-day chart which I saw. In 3-day chart, I saw that price tapped this order block. Okay, so maybe we can see some reversal from here. But there is a two-way possibility here. Okay, because we have a bullish order block as well as the bearish order block. So whenever you see bullish and bearish PD array at the same time, so there is a high chance that price will consolidate at that place. So that thing you have to keep in mind. So there is no clear signal from the chart, okay, what is going to happen. But overall, in this chart, the drawn liquidity will remain this February month low. Okay, this will be our drawn liquidity. and you have to see, you have to wait for more price action here to target this low. But this fair value gap, a tiny one, and also this order block may be responsible for to targeting this February month low, but it's very difficult to say right now. Okay, because I will wait for more price action here to confirm my bias. As of now, it's not straightforward in Euro USD. Okay, so let's go to the next one, GBP USD. It looks good, so I will be waiting for price to tap this fair value gap in weekly chart, and in daily same thing. This looks good, so this will be my range. High, this will be my range low. So if price did not took out this low and it has tapped this high, so now I can target this low, keeping in mind the a bigger range in play in daily, in weekly chart. So let's go to weekly. I'll show one more interesting thing. So if you go to the weekly chart, what do you see? Price took out, price already sucked many traders here. It has closed above it, and the obvious target will be this low, and we also have a monthly fair value gap here. So it makes sense to target this fair value gap. So GU will have some more clear, more good price action than Euro. So the we'll keep an eye on GU rather than on EU. Okay, because if you see, price took out the December high in March, so we can target this February low as well as December low, and eventually going into this fair value gap. But how can we do? We have a tiny fair value gap as well as we have a range which is formed, and we also have a fair value gap just above it, so that makes a pretty good range to trade, and we also have an order block. So this is a good, we have a weekly fair value gap, we have a daily order block, so it makes sense for price to come back again and take out this liquidity, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 days high. This is a 5 day high, and eventually targeting this low. So this is, the bias is pretty much clear for GU, but EU it's not that straightforward. So we'll be waiting for more price action in EU, but in GU it looks pretty straightforward. Okay, and let's go to crypto, which is Bitcoin. Let's go to monthly chart. So in monthly, we'll wait for tomorrow. I guess tomorrow we'll see a monthly closing. And so if price fails to close above this monthly high, okay, and that is 69,145, okay, then I can expect some retracement. But I can say as of now, and also if you see if price fails to close below this weekly high, this, if it closes below this 4th March weekly candle, then I can expect price to target this again, targeting this weekly fair value gap. Okay, the overall draw will be this weekly fair value gap. Until then, 3-day looks bullish. Daily, yes. So how can you trade this? So in daily, wait for candle like this, to suck mini traders. Okay, so if you see a bullish candle taking out this high, and eventually, or what you can do, or what we can do, that we can wait for price to close below this fair value gap. That makes this an inversion, and we can target the weekly fair value gap. Else, there is one more thing we can do. This can be range high. This can be range low. So wait for 4-hour bearish PDR to form. and we can target this weekly favel gap as daily favel gap, which can be your short term trade. So the 12 hour and 4 hour will make sense here. So there's nothing clear here, it's consolidating. So look for, wait for some displacement to the downside, and then only we can will participate. But overall, we'll look for weekly closing here. If price fails to close below this low, we are bearish. And also in monthly, if price fails to close below this low, $69,000, then we are bearish. Not extremely bearish, but we can see some retracement to the this weekly favel gap. That is all from this BTC. But we will wait. It's very ideal to wait for monthly as well as weekly closing to have a clear bias in BTC USD. Okay, now let's go to one more chart, which is USD CAD. USD CAD, I can say anything else monthly, like it is consolidating, to be honest. So it's very difficult right now, so I would either wait for more price action to form here, and I will then only I'll participate in this. Okay, daily, it's very difficult, but the draw would be this equal highs. But every time you see equal highs, it doesn't need to take out immediately. But I will wait. And New Zealand dollar. So if DXY is bullish, so all these pairs will be bearish. I have explained Euro, GBP, and DXY. So hopefully you will have some pretty much good idea about this. Okay. And BTC, I have said. Let's go to the Ethereum. What do we have in Ethereum? And then after that we will take your doubts. Okay, Ethereum did not came to this weekly favel gap. Okay, so there is no. Okay, so Ethereum. Okay, so Ethereum also looks good. So this is the order block we have. The price fails to close above this candle high, we can target this monthly favel gap. So this looks bearish for me, targeting this low. 3 day, if it can, this is also a good order block. But okay, same thing, it is consolidating. Wait for clear displacement, do not try to predict. But overall it looks bearish. Let's use this. We are also in the 50% of this range. So there is a high possibility that there will be a huge bullish candle here. Okay, it will try to suck many traders as it can, then we can see this person to the downside. But we'll wait for this monthly closing, it will give you much more clear idea. So we'll wait. Okay, but the bias is bearish and the drawn liquidity will be $3,055. So that's all. We have the pretty much everything I have covered. USD JPY looks bullish and all these pairs looks bearish. Okay, then let's start with your doubts, guys.